one is off. Paisley's checked in for Orlando. He hits the second from the line. Orlando, they've gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Mann passes to Isaac. Five to shoot. The shot by Beasley, no good.
He has to make that one. I mean, you have to make the defense pay when they slough off of you like that.
Wiggins kicks to Smith. Launches it. Cranes the three-pointer.
Nice play, and you can see they're gathering momentum.
You know, they need to stay aggressive here. Build the lead up while they've got the chance. Don't waste this opportunity.
Now, here's Suggs. Really disappointing game for him in that loss to Chicago. Here's Beasley. They need this. And Pluck. That one goes careening off the glass. Here's Wiggins. The second effort. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. It goes on Jalen Johnson.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you can hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
And Jabari Smith, of course, with deep family ties, Greg, to the NBA.
His dad being the OG Jabari. All these guys are in that 6'10", 6'11 range. So great bloodlines.
The first one falls, and Orlando making a change here. Eubanks has checked in. He's off on the second. Well, Greg, analysts evaluate player performances on the floor, and sometimes we've seen the players fire back. They're not happy with the criticism.
You know, it's a risk you take, but if you treat everyone with kid gloves, you're really not doing your job. The audience expects a level of honesty, and quite frankly, players don't mind you criticizing their games when those critiques become personal.
And so here's Orlando after the missed three from Stephen Curry. Passes it to Isaac. No one near Suggs as he lets it go. Once again off the mark, Orlando. Smith, the pass to Morant. Outside Curry. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Last outing for Houston, it was a loss to the Bucks in Milwaukee. They could use a bucket, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and two shots coming up. Jabari Smith picks one up.
Gotta like the aggressiveness there inside from Isaac. Not afraid to mix it up and go into the defender.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
And this season, he's maintained very good form at the line, shooting at about an 83% clip.
And boy, I tell you what, he's really coming to his own this year. I mean, that is an enormous step up from what he shot at the line last season.
Shooting two.
That's good from Isaac.
Well, this guy packs a nice skill set, Jonathan Isaac. A slender big man who has nice range and is a superb defender already.
A new lineup here for Houston. And both free throws good for Isaac. And so it's Houston with it. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Orlando this season.
And it was a matchup you thought they would have cruised through, but they actually dropped a game in this series last year.
You know, it was 1-1 split from two teams on the opposite side of the standing. And, you know, as we've said many times, Anything can happen when you play out of conference.
Now here's Jones. He gives his team some nice contributions, averaging a bit over 10 points a game. Here's Abaji. He's guarded by Thomas. And that one's good, Abaji.
Yeah, another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively here so far.
Here's Thomas. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. Another miss by Orlando. And here's Houston. Big run right now going for him, 11-2. Refined Shangoon. Now here's Graham. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Graham sees the foul coming and makes sure to get the shot off. That's just a smart move by Devontae.
Houston shooting their fifth and six free throws of the game. First free throw is good.
And, you know, in my opinion, Graham needs to focus on being more consistent. Raising those shooting percentages, I think, goes a long way to his development.
And Orlando making a change here. Harris has checked in. And good on the second, so he makes them both. And so it's Jones. He'll bring it up for Orlando. They trail by 11. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to Chicago.
You got to give them an A for effort. Just fell a little bit short in that one.
Yeah, they were really close right there. Just couldn't string together a few key plays to help get them over the top for the win.
Their play on both ends has been superb. We'll see if they can maintain the momentum.
And, you know, nothing like getting an opponent on the ropes early. You love that if you're on that side of the scoreboard, and they are landing some haymakers now.
They've been sensational on the backboard to start this game.
Yeah, sensational is a really good word for it. They're tearing it up on the glass.
Here's Abaji. Not a good performance from him in that loss to Milwaukee. And it's sent back by Isaac. Pass to Jones. Here's Harris. 56 seconds left in the first. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
First person. Harris's confidence and physicality and determination allow him to draw fouls as he gets close to the basket.
For Orlando, they have had two chances at the line already, making them both.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That's good from Harris.
His improvement each year in the league is impressive. Harris knows his role is to score the ball, and he does it well.
Baisley's checked in for Isaac. Both shots good from the stripe.
And that's the norm for him. He's pretty much automatic when he's at the line.
Graham, the pass to Smith. And here's Kennard. It's good, the assist that time from Smith.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
And, you know, it's an all-out effort they've come in with. Very aggressive offense so far.
Now, here's Thomas. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. Another miss by Orlando. 27 seconds left to play in the first. Teardrop shot, and Kennard finishes it off.
Graham's court awareness in action right there. Easily spots a wide open man.
Thomas feeling it out a bit. Pulls from the top of the key. That shot off the mark.
Very dangerous to lead a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the defense.
And a double-digit lead on the scoreboard as we end the first quarter of play.
Houston
leads by 16. And we'll be back in just a moment with the start of the second quarter. 10 so far through one quarter. It's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And looking at what we've seen from Houston, what do you guys think?
You got to credit their defense, communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
They've got them rattled. It's only the first quarter, and already they've made enough big plays on defense to last really an entire game.
Orlando with the ball. It's a 16-point game. So on the floor for Houston. Smith is out there with Ja Morant. Then it's Smith. Then it's Wiggins. And it's Kennard in at the three, the small forward. Just four to shoot. Here's Mann. That one, no good. And Houston the other way now. Here's Morant. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Almost no holes in their performance tonight. They've been tremendous.
That was the 2K drive, as that move deserved another look.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
And the call will be against Jabari Smith. That'll be his second foul of the game. Getting another opportunity here to see that powerful rejection.
And that has got to help the morale of this team. Let's see if that sets up a run here.
Ochai Agbaji. Stephen Curry.
Here's Mann. He's still scoreless so far in this one. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
Personal foul.
That one's on Morant. And you talk to the great ball handlers, and they say, Greg, that footwork is an underappreciated aspect of it. Why is that?
It's like a dance. You're eluding the defender mostly with your feet. The ball handling part is just making sure the ball comes along for the ride.
And he knocks down the first one. He hits both from the stripe. Houston leading by 16. Morant passes to Agbaji. No one near Curry as he lets it go. And another three for Houston.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
Here's Mann. They look to him for part of their offensive attack. Right now, he averages nearly 12 points a game.
Orlando foul. Number 9. Second personal foul.
Jonathan Isaac. He's checked in for Orlando.
Jonathan Isaac.
Second quarter of action. About a minute and a half played. And it's blocked. On the wing, Isaac. Drills the three-pointer. Isaac's got five.
Boy, nice rhythm that time. See how Isaac let it fly right off the catch? That shows you confidence in the jumper.
Here's Agbaji. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. They get it back. Beasley passes to Mann. Just three to shoot. Here's Isaac. And finally, that one's good. He has seven.
Well, you have to keep Isaac off the boards. I mean, when he's that close to the rim and has good position, he's a threat to grab a bunch of rebounds.
Now here's Morant. He had a 24-point outing in their last game against Milwaukee. Wiggins trying to free himself up. Got it. Good job in the low post. Şengün's got his first bucket in this one. Isaac outside. Pass to Mann. And it's Morant with the rebound.
You know, sometimes making it difficult for him to finish at the rim is all you can ask for from the defense.
And so the ball goes out of bounds. Isaac touched it left. And now the latest from our reporter, David Alder.
Thanks very much. The reviews have been good for the league's moves to eliminate foul calls on non-basketball moves. The NBA said it wanted the game to be played, not manipulated. Draymond Green says it helps to know that you'll have more of a fair opportunity as a defender. Guys can't just cheat the system. Kevin, back to you.
That's great to see, David. Thank you.
And when he's on the floor, offensive rebounding is always going to be a strength for them.
Greg, he keeps so many possessions alive, doesn't he?
And, you know, those second-chance opportunities can be game-changing. He represents so much value to this team because of what he does.
And it'll be Orlando with their first time out of the game right here.
And the lack of rim protection, top.
At the point guard position, at 6 feet, number 15, Jose Alvarado. At center, 6'11", number 4, Steven Adams. Starting at small four, 6 feet, 7 inches. Number 41, Sadiq Bey. The other four, standing 6'8", number 13, Keegan Murray. The other ball, standing 6'5", number 1, Devin Booker. The head coach of your home team, right here to go, Memphis Grizzlies.
Happy weekend, everyone. It's the NBA on Saturday night, presented to you live on 2K Sports. Along with Grant Hill and Richard Jefferson, this is Brian Anderson, and we've got our reporter, Allie LaForce. Allie, it's all yours.
Thanks, Brian. Desmond Bane slipped to the 30th pick in 2020, and he said, quote, "I will not forget that. I take it personally. I've been that way ever since I was a kid. Growing up in Richmond, Indiana, a small town, you got to fight for respect, and that's what I've been doing my whole life. EA?"
He's proven himself, Allie. Thank you. Now the starting group for the visitors. We've got Chris Paul, Ivica Zubac out there with Kevin Durant. Then there's Tyler Hero, and it's Terry in at the three. And for the Grizzlies, we've got Sadiq Bey, Murray out there with Steven Adams. Then there's Devin Booker, and it's Alvarado in at point guard. A battle of two terrific front courts here. The rare night when guards take a back seat, Richard.
Times have changed. Front courts used to dominate the game. I remember in the 90s when it was Shaquille O'Neal, Hakeem Olajuwon, Patrick Ewing. That's when the game was dominated by bigs. But then once spacing happened, now tonight it looks like an old 90s basketball game.
Now here's Paul to the inside. Oh, can't finish the one-handed jam. Durant against Murray. Tries again. Kept alive. Bay outside. Clock at six. The three is up. Oh, the Grizzlies get it back. To the paint. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Part of what makes KD an all-timer, we have never seen someone his size with that type of hand.
That free throw misses.
In 2008, Kevin Durant ran away with the Rookie of the Year award. It wasn't even really close. And still, I'm not sure we realize what an all-time great he'd become.
And the Grizzlies making a change here. Cousins has checked in. And the second free throw is good. Turns out that Durant's rookie season was the worst of his career, Richard.
And he was fantastic that year. But within two seasons, he'd become the league leader in scoring. His rebounding would improve, and by then, we knew we were watching a Hall of Famer.
Now here's Booker. He's been a big scorer for this offense, averaging around 20 points a game. Bay from long range. Ooh, the Grizzlies with another miss.
Just brutal. I mean, five straight misses to begin the game.
Here's Hero. Softly drops in the floater.
There's a touch of artistry to the floater. Takes feel as much as skill.
And that streaking rack attack is the mobile one drive.
Yeah, taking the onus on himself to make something happen. Got it into the teeth of the defense and made them pay.
Alvarado. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two. It goes on Chris Paul.
First team. At the line for minutes, Jose Alvarado, taking two shots.
Two.
First free throw is good. And you can tell how much these fans here in Memphis love their Grizzlies.
Yeah, I mean, B.A., ever since they moved here in 2001, these fans have been so loyal. And the players are also enjoy playing here. Memphis is a fun-loving city with great barbecue and a lot of character.
Simons has checked in for Chris Paul. Here's Simons. Pass to Terry. Now here's Hero. Ooh, he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair.
Second team foul. At the line for the away team, Tyler Hero. Two shots.
Take a break. Two shots.
And he makes the first. Porter Jr., he's checked in for Devin Booker. Good on both.
Two-part equation. You have to be aggressive enough to get to the line, then talented enough to sink them.
Here's Alvarado. He's covered by Simons. Takes a 13-footer, and that one's long.
I think the defense will live with him taking mid-range jumpers, but maybe just a little bit more resistance.
And the 17-footer goes down.
And hitting from the mid-range here and early. I mean, really gives the defense just another thing to worry about.
And you don't see many teams take these shots as often anymore. It's nice to see them take advantage in this area.
Cousins for three. Nails it from beyond the arc.
With good timing and a sound jump shot, Cousins is able to convert catch-and-shoot opportunities.
And he lobs it up. Deflects the pass. Bay passes to Porter. Ooh, can't tie it up as that one's no good.
And he's usually able to score on that type of defense rather easily. Surprising to see him come away empty.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
Easy possessions like that literally are just a gift. You just dream of them. He'll gladly take those.
Pass to Alvarado. Cousins down low. No good that time. And it's Portland the other way. They're getting their first look of the season at the Grizzlies in this one.
They'll be looking for payback after grabbing the short straw in the season series last year.
Now here's Porter. Here's Alvarado. So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. That's on Anthony Simons. With the trade deadline approaching, RJ, the rumor mill has been active. How does that affect a player when their names are being mentioned in trade rumors?
Well, it can be a blow to your confidence, and it makes it tough to trust the organization at times. And if players are well-liked, it can tear a locker room apart. I've seen it.
And he knocks down the first one. And some changes here for the Grizzlies. Aldama's checked in for Cousins, and it's Horton Tucker in for Adams. And so he hits both. Here's Simons. He's been contributing over 15 a game. Outside Bogdanovich. Now here's Durant. He's closely guarded. Off the mark with the outside fadeaway.
That was a good look for him from mid-range, but just couldn't make the defense pay.
That ties it up.
We see this every night. He has the skill and versatility to keep a defense guessing.
Simons finds Durant outside Bane. Pass to Bogdanovich. And it's off from three-point range. The Grizzlies on offense.
Offensively, it was never their night. The issues they suffered were pretty clear.
Won't win games in this league with an offensive night like that. They've got some things to figure out.
Now here's Durant. Last game for him, he had 14. Bane, no good. Here's Horton Tucker, defended by Bogdanovich. Another shot. The rebound by Bogdanovich. For Portland, they've gone 3 of 8 so far. Oh, he picked him clean. Bay against Bogdanovich. Bay, no good.
You gotta credit the defense this period. They've been all over him.
Well, Grant, looking at the career of Bojan Bogdanovic, he's been so steady.
Yes, he has, B.A. He's really Mr. Consistency. Always averages double figures, always shoots it well from three. Bojan can play the three or the four, someone you can really rely on as a teammate.
Timeout called, the Grizzlies.
Yeah, hoping to tap into something that'll get them clicking.
Yeah, they need to regroup and maybe try and draw something up that can get them a clean look at the basket.
To Horton Tucker. Just 5 on the clock. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Everyone in the building saw the obvious contact.
At the line for your Grizzlies, Talen Horton Tucker. At the line for two.
First one falls for him. Zubats, he's checked in for Durant. That one falls, so he hits both of them. For Portland, they've gone 4 of 9 in this one so far. Outside Bogdanovich. That three's off the mark.
Grab that one. However, so far they're getting a little out-hustled on the boards.
Horton Tucker can't hit. Well, Portland's shooting around 40% early on here. Bain against Porter. Fades back. Bain, no good.
Good idea with the fadeaway, but the defense was just all over it.
Just 2 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Outside Porter. Simons with a steal. It's a tie game in Memphis. Let's take a quick break, and then it's on to the second quarter after this. In the books as we get back to a game that's been pretty close so far here. What stands out to you from the Grizzlies in this one?
Well, it's simple. When you can dominate the boards at both ends, you can control the second chance touches.
In rebounding numbers, sometimes we overlook them, but they can have a big effect on the outcome.
So it's the Grizzlies now. On the court right now for Portland. Bojan Bogdanovic out there with Ivica Zubats. Then there's Chris Paul. Then there's Tyler Hero. And it's Terry in at the three.
What you have to admire about Devin Booker is how much he scores the rock, as well as all the different ways he's able to finish.
That free throw, no good. And Booker is a guy you can lean on to help shoulder the offensive load, Richard.
Yeah, he's comfortable taking a lot of shots for his team. He's a volume shooter for a reason, because he understands how to score at an efficient clip, too.
And now they lead as the free throw drops in for him.
The thing about Booker is he rarely has an off night. He's one of the most consistent shooters in the league.
And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Paul. And it's the Grizzlies with the ball. Here's Alvarado. Outside Booker. After missing his first attempt, now 1 for 2.
Muscling his way through the contact. Love the edge that Booker plays with.
And that replay showed how sensational that drive truly was.
Yeah, and in close games like this one, B.A., you need toughness. Guys who will run to the fight and get after it.
Here's Terry. In his last outing, 8 points for him. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up. You know, the point forward is an archetype that by now fans are familiar with. Grant, you were one of the OGs at the point forward. How's that position evolved in your mind?
Well, it's evolved because so many players today have the skill set to be a point forward. Before me, there were guys like Paul Pressey and Scottie Pippen in the 80s and early 90s. But as I said, players today, the skill level is so elite. And with this positionless basketball that we're in, you must have a point forward or two on your team to be successful.
Kevin Durant, he's checked in for Zubats. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. Memphis leading. Pass to Alvarado. Back to Booker. The three. They get it back. Here's Cousins. Three-pointer. And Alvarado gets it to go. He's got seven.
This has been a close game in a lot of ways, but they do have an edge on the boards.
Hero outside. Pass to Terry. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. Outside Booker. And here's Adams. He's guarded by Hero. And there's Adams. That one's good. On the assist by Booker. Adams has gotten his first points in this one. Now Hero. Pass to Bogdanovich. No good on the triple. For Memphis, they've gotten three of four field goals in the second quarter. Booker, the pass to Adams. Banked it in off the glass. And now it's an eight-point Memphis lead.
You can really feel the momentum swinging in their direction.
Yeah, but they can't relax. They've got to keep building on this lead because it is not safe.
Here's Terry. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. The Grizzlies on offense. They're on a 10-2 run here. Bogdanovich against Murray, and he can't extend the lead to double digits. They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
Hero finds Paul. Here's Terry, six to shoot. Bogdanovich up top. Offline with a three.
Their strong work ethic has been evident on the glass. Really getting after it and being physical.
For Portland, they've gone 0 for 4 in the second quarter. Pass to Durant. Hero with it. He's picked up by Adams. Hero, no good. The Grizzlies have gone 4 for 7 in the second quarter. Outside Murray. Let's it fly. Murray can't get that one to fall.
Oh, man, he can't get anything to fall. You can feel his frustration.
Yeah, right now, he's just in his own head. Not much you can do to try and push through.
Timeout.
Oh, yeah, that'll do it.
Wow, an emphatic two-handed slam. Timeout called, Memphis.
You could really see his squad was losing steam. Smart timeout to give them a breather.
Grizzlies. Aldama's checked in for Adams. Bay comes in for Cousins. And it's Porter Jr. in for Alvarado. Now here's Bay. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Pass to Porter. Shot clock at six. Oh, the Grizzlies get it back. And the whistle blows on a backcourt violation. Went over and back. And the Grizzlies making a change here. Horton Tucker's checked in. Bain, the pass to Simons. Now here's Durant. He's got five. Porter pulls it in. Pass to Horton Tucker. Count that one. And the Grizzlies lead by eight.
Their ball movement on this run has been tremendous. It's led to a lot of good, clean, open looks.
Outside Bogdanovich. He shoots. Oh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take two free throws now.
You know, you watch Bogey and how he can orchestrate. He's an underrated playmaker, Grant.
Yeah, B.A., the assist numbers don't jump out at you, but he has great court vision at all times, runs the pick and roll well, and is shifty in the paint.
Shooting two.
First one at the line is good. RJ, you played with some of the greats. LeBron, Duncan, Dirk, Jason Kidd, just to name a few. But if the game were on the line, who would you want taking the last shot? Putting you on the spot here.
I'm going to be really honest. I have been in great situations with all of those guys, and they have all delivered. So this isn't, but I'm going to go with the person that's delivered the biggest shot of my career, and that was Kyrie Irving, and he hit the clutchest shot in NBA history. Argue with me if you want. You're going to lose it.
No argument here. Bay outside. Five on the clock. Over Bogdanovich. Bay, no good. Simons against Porter. There's Bogdanovich with the three. The Grizzlies pull it in. Murray's got four rebounds in the game. Bogdanovich against Bay. Outside Porter. From deep three-point range. Can't get it to drop. And it's Portland the other way.
And that one, the other team could not keep up with them offensively. They were prolific.
And on top of probably having the better talent, they never let up. Great effort, great win.
Now here's Bogdanovich. Taking a look at his production. Averaging just over 8 points a game.
And when you're trailing in a game, it can be tempting to try to go for the big play.
Porter, the pass to Bay. Outside Porter. Over Simons. And another miss by Memphis.
Well, the defense didn't have any impact on that shot, but somehow he still misses it.
Takes one from 10 feet. And that one's good. That makes him 2 for 3.
Oh, he'll wear you down with the way he grinds it out on the offensive glass.
Porter, the pass to Bay. 19 seconds left in the first half. Here's Porter. Sinks that one from the post. Porter's got his second basket of the night.
Used the pick to perfection and got all the way to the rim.
From 17, it's wide right, hits off the rim. And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. Grizzlies out in front, up four. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back out there for the start of the third quarter, right after the break.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And we hope you enjoyed the competitive first half of action. Ernie Johnson here welcoming you back to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. That guy right there is Shaquille O'Neal, and that guy right there is Kenny the Jet Smith. For the Grizzlies, the first quarter was pretty even. They stayed within arm's reach in that opening period, 5 points, their largest deficit. In the second quarter, they put in the work to create a slight scoring advantage. Kenny, what'd you think about the Grizzlies?
We have to love the second unit. I mean, the effort they displayed, they're doing much more than we thought it would. We're seeing real intensity from them, particularly on the offensive.
And Shaq, let's get your input on the visiting team.
They've got to be more assertive on the glass. Without hustle, it's a great way to lose a game. In the second half, they can generate extra possessions. It will go a long way towards getting the W.
And that's a wrap for our halftime show. The third quarter just about to get started.
Second half of basketball is upon us, and we may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game we've seen so far. Memphis leading. Murray out there with Sadiq Bey. Then it's Steven Adams. Then there's Devin Booker. And it's Alvarado in at the point. That's the lineup in the game for Memphis. Here's Adams. Great D that time from Zubats. Portland's shooting a rough 29% from the field here. Pass to Durant. There's the drive. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up. It's going to be on Sadiq Bey.
The shot-making ability of Durant is what makes his pump fake so terrifying. It gets defenders off balance and leads to the foul.
Throws good from Durant.
You look at Durant's game and you instantly see all the hours of hard work that went into shaping it. He's so polished in every area. His skills are so sharp.
And both free throws good for Durant. And the Grizzlies shooting only 26% for this game. Not good. Here's Alvarado. He's guarded by Paul. Just five to shoot. Knocked loose and stolen by Durant. And here they come. This for the tie. No good. A bit long that time. Outside Booker. Pass to Adams. Bay outside. Memphis needs to get off a shot. Alvarado. Misses the three. Now here's Paul. That's good from Durant. On the assist from Paul. Durant's gotten four this quarter.
Sharp find by Paul. One of the best passes of all time.
Pass to Murray. Here's Alvarado. And a miss there on the triple.
Off to a bit of a slow start in the second half. 0 for 3 so far.
Hero against Booker. Here's Terry. For the lead. Sinks it from Pistons.
Timeout.
Now it's a three-point Portland lead.
His three-point shot looks so pure. The defense allowing him to get comfortable out there.
Memphis calls timeout.
Yeah, they're hoping to turn things around with this timeout.
On the wrong side of a scoring run here, we might see a lineup change. I'll be pretty curious.
For Memphis, they've gone 0 for 3 to start the second half. Bay outside. Here he goes. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Second personal foul.
And Sadiq Bey, a 3 and D wing. And he has the strength to play up at the power forward spot, Greg.
You know, B.A., that power forward spot might be his best position. Not the quick twitch type of athlete, but great physicality for a perimeter player.
Take a break. Two shots.
He misses the free throw. And he's good on the second. Second half of play here with just under 2.5 minutes passed. Pass to Hero. And he lays it up and in. Hero's got 6 points.
A nice start to the second half. They've made 3 out of their first 4 shots coming out of the break.
That was another look at our Mobile One drive of the game just a moment ago.
And, you know, a close game, you got to find that edge. High-energy plays like that one can make a big difference.
Ooh, the Grizzlies with another miss. Now Portland with it. They're on a 9-1 run. Paul for three. Oh, Adams with the block.
Oh, a fantastic defender. Adams embraces his role on this team as their defensive anchor.
Bay passes to Cousins. Outside for Bay. The floater, and it's good on the layup.
The floater is so tough to defend against. Nothing defenders can really do but shake their heads.
Pass to Terry. Here's Durant. Oh, the swat by Adams. Here's Cousins. And the layup is good off the glass. Cousins has got his second basket on the night.
And that's just grown man strength from Cousins there. Able to fend off the physical defense. Nice play.
Pass to Alvarado. Booker with it for the lead. Excellent D there from Hero. Left side Paul. Zubats. Yes. And it's Paul with the assist that time. And Portland leads by 2.
The defense couldn't collapse quickly enough.
Bay outside. Let's it go from deep. Adams. It's good on the putback. Adams has got his 3rd bucket of the night.
And on the offensive end, this is how Adams hurts you. You have to be aware of where he is at all times.
Timeout called. Portland. In 2013, Steven Adams was selected 12th overall by OKC, the first first-rounder born in New Zealand.
Yeah, B.A., well, I mean, Adams is blazing a new trail. An example for kids in his home island of New Zealand. You, too, can become an NBA player.
Some changes. Aldama's checked in for Cousins. Gordon Tucker comes in for Booker. And it's Porter Jr. in for Alvarado. Bain, he's checked in for Portland. Simons comes in for Paul. Now here's Simons. The shot. And it's good. Off the back rim and in. Simons has got 6 points.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
Yeah, as soon as these guys feel contact, they are just disappearing like they're not even there. You gotta show some fire and keep defending.
Here's Adams. Uses the glass on the layup. Give him 8 points now.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. You know, that's why they continue to get attacked.
Here's Terry. It's rebounded by Memphis. Here's Bay. That one drops, and it comes off an assist from Porter. Bay's got 5 points in the quarter.
Soft interior D, and they've exploited it.
Here's Terry. 5 points in the game. Durant for three. Porter pulls it in.
And he probably thought he was going to bury that one.
Pass to Bay. Outside for Porter. And they get it back.
And his teammates appreciate the energy. Nice job to keep the possession going.
And here's Adams. And he gets that one. And the Grizzlies lead by four.
This run has been fueled by their Matador defense.
Porter against Simons. And stolen by Bay. 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Porter. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
Second personal foul.
That's on Anthony Simons.
The officials were right on top of that
one. Line for your Grizzlies. Kevin Porter Jr. taking two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw, no good. Cousins, he's checked in for Memphis. Murray comes in for Aldama. And he sinks the second. For Portland, they've gotten 5 of 10 shots to go. About 3 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Durant against Murray. And Durant gets it to go. Durant's got 11.
So polished from the interior. Durant is terrific at utilizing his physical advantages down on the block.
And Cousins gets it to go on the assist by Porter. Porter's got 3 assists now in this one. And we've reached the end of the third. It's the Grizzlies. They lead by 5. After a quick break, we're coming right back with the start of the fourth quarter. And let's take this opportunity to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
You have to love his unselfishness and ability to make those around him better.
He does do a great job steering the ship for them out there and keeping the offense clicking.
Three tense quarters behind us. One more to go. Thanks for being with us as we get ready for the fourth. On the court right now for Portland, we've got Ivica Zubac. Anthony Simons out there with Tyler Hero. Then it's Desmond Bane. And it's Terry in at the power forward position. And no lack of aggression on that move. Good for the 2K drive. Memphis leading. On the wing, Bay. Pass to Booker. Lets it go. And yes, it goes. Got a little English on that one.
Instantaneous offense. Booker gets the hot pass and quickly has that shot in the air.
Back to Simons. Here's Hero. Booker defending. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Pulls up. Rebounded by Cousins. Cousins has got 4 rebounds now.
You wonder what the score would be if they weren't controlling the glass.
And with this skill, you don't forget that Booker is 6'5" and can get to the rim with ease.
Pass to Terry. The offensive rebound.
That is not a bad decision to pull from there. It was just a little bit off with the execution.
Booker for 3. No luck on that one. And it's Portland the other way.
And even though he hasn't been himself, it hasn't affected his team too much. They've still got the lead.
And a little over a minute and a half gone by in the fourth. Time called here. The Grizzlies decide to talk it over.
Failing to find a rhythm offensively. Something that needs to change and change soon.
And coach called his timeout to try and reset things on offense. Shake them up a bit so they can hopefully start getting some shots to fall.
Thank you. checked in for Simons. All right, let's get a report from Allie.
Thanks, guys. Head coach of the Grizzlies had some words for his team over the break. He told his squad to pour on the gas, saying, quote, "We hold the lead. Let's keep growing it. Be aggressive. This is no time to let up."
Good job there, Allie. Thanks. Here's Paul. The Grizzlies making their last shot. And he drives in. From 13. Second chance shot. Zubats. Unable to get that one. Good work defensively by Cousins.
And they've committed to controlling the boards, and it's paying dividends.
Hey, good.
You know, they're really being bullied right now defensively. 8 of the last 10 points have come from inside.
Pass to Zubats. The ball's knocked loose. Cousins with the steal. Now here's Porter. Outside Booker. Here's Murray. Outside Booker. 5 to shoot. Shoots over Hero. No good off the back of the rim.
And they're up right now, but it hasn't been because of him. He's really struggled on offense.
From behind the arc. And the rebound goes to the Grizzlies. Murray's got 6 rebounds here tonight. From 8 feet. And Cousins gets it to go. On the assist by Murray. And the Grizzlies lead by 11. Outside Bane. And a strong finish with 2 hands.
Now that's how you use the screen right there.
And it leads to a thunderous finish. That was nice.
Yeah, you like the pick to set up the open shot. But when it leads to a dunk, okay, even better, we'll take it.
Hey, good.
Didn't get a 3 in the first half, but now he's on the board with his first triple of the game.
Timeout called, Portland.
Protecting the rim has to be their top objective right now.
I'm sure coach is going to give them an earful about that. He can't be happy with that soft interior D.
Impossible to cool off, hitting just about everything he looks at. It doesn't matter who's guarding him. He's had an answer for just about everyone.
I'll tell you, this team depends on him to lead them, and he did just that tonight. He doesn't take this responsibility lightly. You could tell it was important for him to grab a win here. Now here's Paul. Outside Bane. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
No debate there. He got hammered.
All right, guys, what do you think so far about the offensive approach for the Grizzlies?
2 shots.
And he drops the first. He's perfect from the line this time.
They're doing some good work at the line this half.
For Memphis, they've gotten 6 of 8 shots to fall during this fourth. Pass to Alvarado. Zubats against Cousins. Here's Alvarado. Jacks up a three. And it's Bane with the rebound. Bane's got 4 rebounds now. Over Cousins. It's rebounded by Memphis. Cousins has got 6 rebounds in the game. Here's Booker. Knocks down the step back Jay. And the Grizzlies lead by 12.
Crafty play by Booker inside, navigating to a point blank look at the basket.
Here's Durant. Rebounded by Cousins. Cousins has got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Misses off the right iron. Well, Portland's shooting around 30% since the fourth quarter got underway. Here's Bane. That shot is off. Booker with the defensive effort. And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
You're not going to fool the officials too often on an illegal screen.
That's a very avoidable turn. You've got to focus on the details.
And what a phenomenal replay of that impressive rejection.
Your good offense comes from great defense. This lead is only getting stronger with plays like that.
Steven Adams checked in for Memphis. Now here's Durant. Over Murray. Durant's shot is off. And here's Memphis. They're on a 15-6 run. Outside Booker. 6 on the shot clock. Pass to Adams. It goes again. His 6th basket and 7 tries.
And there's no way this margin gets closed down. Great execution of a game plan and a nice win here for the Grizzlies.
They had to fight for this one. With the game hanging in the balance a couple of times, they made winning plays, Grant.
It's all about having a strong mentality. What's interesting is that any time momentum turned against them, instead of folding, they responded with their own attack.
And this win will give them 12 on the year thus far.
And against a non-conference opponent, you really want to win the first one. They'll go into the next one knowing how to beat this team for sure.
And one player just stole the show tonight, doing everything for his team. A monster night for Steven Adams.
Honestly, I just love how relentless he is on the glass, making a big effort to pull the ball in and give his teammates extra chances.
Here's Durant. The Grizzlies making their last shot. Over Adams. Durant, no good. And stolen by Durant. Oh, wasted no time on that one.
Well, Durant must be making the defense sweat a little bit right now. Whenever he gets into a rhythm, he gets aggressive.
Bane against Booker. Into the lane. Lays it up and banks it in.
And guys, that's got to be the dagger. This is how you finish a game.
And it felt like they just flipped the switch to go on that run and seal the game. Saving their best basketball for the end. Always smart.
Terry, that's good. And so Durant with the assist.
The elevated playmaking of Durant. Passes like that really bring the team closer together.
And so Memphis takes this one by a big margin. Even early on in this game, they appeared happy to be playing at home.
And it makes a huge difference. Once they started to get into a groove, you never really felt like they wouldn't come out on top.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. This is Brian Anderson saying thank you for watching. So long and good night, everyone.
for the visiting team. At point guard, Max Christie. At center, Victor Zero. At small forward, Shaden Sharp. At the other forward position, Evan Mobley. At the other guard position, Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. The head coach of the visiting team is Steve Kerr. Let's meet your home team. At the power forward position, standing 6'5", number 41, Caleb Martin. At point guard, standing 6'2", number 12, Highland. Manning the middle, 7'1", number 27, Rudy Gobert. The other forward, standing 6'8", number 4, Scotty Barnes. The other guard, 6'4", number 1, Anthony Edwards.
Welcome, sports fans. Thanks for joining us. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Hall of Famer Doris Burke and Greg Anthony, giving us the rundown from the sideline courtside, David Aldridge. Hey, Dave.
Thank you very much. Now, the calls to shorten the NBA season continue. One NBA president has even suggested a 58-game schedule. And for the playoffs, one and done. He says there's a reason people tune into every football game. The college tournament in 63 games gets more TV money than we do in our entire regular season. The more drama, the more TV ratings, the more money. Kevin?
What's not to like? Everything makes sense. Rest the players, more practice time, and all the things you just talked about. Maybe DA less is more. And thanks for the report. So with Williams on the bench, here's the group that Steve Kerr has on the floor. Christie is out there with Gilgeous-Alexander. Then there's Mobley. Then it's Sharp. And for the Timberwolves, we've got Barnes. Martin is out there with Gobert. Then there's Anthony Edwards. And it's Highland in at the point guard position. And now, Greg, that we're into the meat of the season, are you seeing any emerging trends out there?
For a few years, the trend had been guys shooting from farther and farther out. But, Kevin, I think we're seeing a return of the big man, a more concerted effort to attack the interior.
Here's Christie.